वेलकम बैक। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट एनोटेशंस इन टेस्ट एन जी। सो विद दिस एक्चुअली इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी सॉ वॉट इज सॉफ्ट असर्शन। सो दिस इज द कोड फॉर सॉफ्ट असर्शन। बट बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग विद द न्यू टॉपिक आई वुड जस्ट लाइक टू क्रिएट वन मोर मेथड एंड आई विल नेम इट एज सॉफ्ट असर्शन। And here what we will do, we will just remove all the soft assertion that we are using and we will just use normal assert. Okay, we can remove this also. So now we have two test cases, which is for hard assertion and one test case which is with soft assertion. Now if we are going to run both the test case, let us see if it is running fine. So I will just run all the three test cases which are there. So we are just going to fix these two things and we are going to see if it is working fine. So yeah, both of our test case it is working fine. And now what we are going to do, if we can see closely, so there are two test cases and in these two test cases there are some lines of code which we are duplicating, like setting the property, getting the driver object and then navigating to the URL, right? So this line of code and this line of code, they are duplicated. So is it we can do something about these things in order to optimize those things? Yes. So in that case, what we can do, we can just use a simple testng annotation that is being provided by testng, which is before method and one is after method. So these two methods, if in case there is any precondition and postcondition after the test cases, I mean, for before method it is a precondition and after method it is a postcondition after the test case is executed. So if we see closely, this is the line of code which is the duplicate line, and in order to set these things, what we can do, we can create methods in order to have this line of code. So let us go and see how we can settle these things, how we can use before method and after method. So here what we are going to do, we are just going to cut these lines, and after doing these things, what we are going to do, we are going to create one method and we are going to name it as public void, something like driver setup
or just
setup. And here what we are going to do, we are just going to copy paste the text. Now with this, what we can say, our this line of code and this line of code is not needed because we are just using the same thing again, right? So we are just going to remove this thing. And for the driver, what we can do, we can just write and initialize the driver here. So So we are just going to create a local variable and we are created at a class level. Now all our errors are gone and we have also removed the duplicate codes, right? So we are now having as much code which is only required for the test case, right? But here we can see that driver.quit, it is also there, which is a duplicate. So for that we can just create one more method in after method setup, and we can use like public void, maybe teardown, and here we can just write driver.quit. So we are going to just remove this thing and we are going to write it driver.quit. So you can see that with before method and after method we are setting some preconditions and post conditions, and what all common lines of code are there, we are just writing them. So basically it will help in reducing and optimizing our code, and apart from that we are not going to duplicate our code, and this will also be used to set up our driver and maybe the website that we are automating. We are going to launch that, and now we are just going to run this and see if it is working fine or not. So our Chrome browser is launched and we got some error. So let us see what is the error. Okay, maybe I can just keep it here and let me see. Okay, so basically we don't need this here, and with this we don't need this here, and now our code should work fine. Now I will try to execute this thing. So you can see our browser is launched, it is executing the first test case, and now it is executing the second test case, and now actually it won't do anything, it will just launch and it will quit, because this is like the test case which is not doing anything, right? So with this our all the test cases are working fine and we were able to reduce some code also. So that's why we are using before method and after method in order to give any preconditions. So simple thing, if we want to do something before any test cases, we are just going to use before method, and if we are going to do something after the execution of the test case, which is like we are quitting, so we are going to use after method. So before method, anything which we want to do before the test case, and after method, anything which you want to do after the test case, and it will help in creating and optimizing your code. Hope you like my video. Thank you.